Yeah, it's about that time again.
WNLR New Level Radio. New Level Radio. WNLR New Level Radio. Live and direct, live in effect. WNLR New Level Radio.
Welcome to WNLR New Level Radio. I'm your host, N.I.L.E., and we are back, y'all. We are back. It's been a minute. We've been actually upgrading a lot of things. We have a lot going on. And for those of you who are absolutely new to WNLR New Level Radio, let me just give you a brief breakdown if you haven't already read the YouTube channel page and our profile. My name is N.I.L.E., you know what I mean? I was a Christian hip-hop artist slash music producer slash CEO of New Level Entertainment, independent recording label. Basically, what we did was we were running a podcast about 7 or 8 years ago on Blog Talk Radio, the WNLR New Level Radio. You can go and check out those previous episodes. But what we did was we decided to actually bring the podcast back. We stopped it for a minute because we were working on projects. We're still working on movies to be coming out, working on DVD documentaries and plenty of projects. But with all of the actual social topics and the craziness that's going on and everything that's really in social media, WNLR, we wanted to make sure that we brought our platform back to our fans, to our friends, to all the people, you know, who checked us out. You know what I mean? So everybody, you have a million people who have podcasts, and that's all good. You know what I mean? Shout out to everybody that's doing their thing. But what separates WNLR New Level Radio from the rest of the podcast is that we are the only podcast that does multiple podcasts, and they all have different platforms. So essentially, this podcast that we're doing right now is basically episodes. You know, we're talking about the social topics. We're talking about the relevant things. There's no holds barred here. You get to actually comment, and you can comment right on the actual YouTube channel so that once we actually see your comments to whatever our topic of the day is or our topic of the moment is, you can absolutely look at the comments, and people who may agree or disagree can do it right on the board. You know what I mean? Because I think what's important is that we get the dialogue going and we see people's perspective. And a lot of times people can get crazy online and on the internet, you know, even with phone calls. But the bottom line is that the evidence of how people feel is how people feel. But I think we always want to come to a conclusion with our topic of the moment on the reality of the situation. So whatever the topic is, whatever the situation might be, we're going to discuss that. We're going to get in depth. It's going to be very intense. It's going to be very truthful. But main thing is that we keep it respectful. We keep it honest, because you can't go and you can't grow any level to any situation without the honesty and the truth. But the main thing is we give truth and love here. That's kind of how we do, because we faith-based. So bottom line is, again, welcome to WNLR New Level Radio. For those of you just tuning in, I'm your host, N.I.L.E., you know what I mean? So what we're going to do is break down the platform of how we actually run WNLR New Level Radio podcast. What we generally do is we'll go ahead and shout people out, give an actual, you know, brief description of what our actual radio station is, which I just gave you, and we get into the actual topic of the moment, which I'm about to get into right in a second, and I'm so excited about it. So the topic of the moment goes in this format. We give you the topic. Once we give you the topic, you can answer that topic right on our actual YouTube channel. And once you answer it, we actually read every single comment, every single comment. And when we read every single comment, we actually take all of those comments and we actually will post the actual replies on the next actual episode of the podcast. So we'll do continuation. So it just won't be one topic and it'll be one and done. No, we're going to continue to talk about the topic because I know everybody wants a chance to be heard. So what we're going to do is break down the topic of the moment. Once we break it down, people will have a chance to comment on the YouTube actual channel. And once they do, the next podcast will go ahead and reply to those actual comments. And we're going to chop it up. you know, but there's a lot to talk about. So right now, let's get into the topic of the moment for WNLR New Level Radio. And the topic of the moment is the Bill Cosby trial, of which he was convicted. Crazy, crazy news. You got a lot going on in the news with Trump. Got a lot going on with a lot of different people with conspiracies and everything. But this is one of the, by far, biggest social media topics ever. And the reason it's so big with the Bill Cosby conviction, and I want to make sure that I'm saying it right, conviction, because they did find him guilty. I want to just make sure that I make this clear, that I make it very understandable and very unbiased, okay? It's a very, very, very sensitive topic when you're talking about the actual rape charges that Bill Cosby has been charged with. So, again, what we're going to do is we're going to talk about the topic of the moment regarding this case. Now, here's the question, okay? And the question is, do any of you out there believe that Bill Cosby being convicted based on what the jury said, do you believe that Bill Cosby is more guilty than the woman who admitted that she lied about Emmett Till? That's the question. Do you believe that Bill Cosby, with his case and conviction, do you believe that he is more guilty than the woman who came out and admitted that she lied about Emmett Till? And those of you who don't know who Emmett Till is, you can go ahead and look it up on YouTube and it'll give you all the history. So that's the topic of the moment. But here's the thing. I only want the women to answer. I only want the women to answer this because the guys feel a certain way. And since this is a topic about rape, and since the topic about, you know, rape is a very, 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 very sensitive topic, even for women who may have been victims of rape, even for women who have made accusations of rape, I only want the women to answer. And the goal for me just having the women answer this is because, again, this will give the true perspective of why we are where we are when it comes to this actual topic of, quote unquote, you know, allegations of rape, or lack of a better term, what is called rape culture. Okay. Now, I basically, personally for me, I know, and I've said this before, I don't believe, and I know, as a matter of fact, it's not just my belief, it's what I know. Rape is not a culture. You understand? Rape is an act of wickedness, bottom line. So we can't keep giving definitions to things and justifying it as a culture. A culture is deemed a learned behavior. You understand? And the problem is that we learn a lot of things. People say we learn rape. We learn how to mistreat men. We learn how to mistreat women. That's a whole nother topic. But when we're talking about culture, culture has a deeper meaning when it comes to lifestyle, when it comes to tradition, when it comes to religion. You understand what I mean? Rape is not a culture. Rape is an act of wickedness, you know? So I just want to put that out there as far as why I only want the women to absolutely answer. But the topic of the moment is, like I said, do you believe that Bill Cosby, based on his conviction, is more guilty than the woman who admitted that she lied about Emmett Till? You can go ahead and post your comments on the YouTube channel, or you can actually send your comments to newlevel2@msn.com and make sure that you put in the subject line reply to the actual WNLR topic of the moment regarding Bill Cosby. Okay, so you can go ahead and send your comments in. We're going to actually get into some more music. We're going to play some independent music that, you know, we produce at New Level Entertainment. And we're also going to get into some different aspects of interviews with people. We'll take a few phone calls and we'll get back into this topic because I think this is a very important topic that we need to discuss. And I know it's going to be very heated. It's going to be very sensitive. But my goal, or our goal rather, here at WNLR New Level Radio is to let you get it out. Because once you get it out and once you put it on, you know, in public, you can actually use that public as a mirror to reflect back on what you say and the power of your words and the power of what's being said. Because essentially, that's what our broadcast is all about. It's all about empowerment, not just giving people a voice. It's also letting them know the power of their voice, letting them know what they say, letting them know when they say things, the power that comes with their words. Even when you type them on the internet. That is the whole purpose of why WNLR exists. We want to be the funnel and the filter and the channel and the mirror, you understand, for everyone that has a comment. And I'm a firm believer in everybody has a voice. Everybody has the right to express their voice. But there has to be a wisdom in when you talk, because some people just don't realize what they say. I think they speak more on passion as opposed to speaking honestly and understanding that their honesty is their right, but it's not their right to impose on other people who have that same right. All you can do is put it out there, and whatever comes back from the universe, it comes back. But again, we all have to have self-accountability. Our self-accountability for where we stand, our self-accountability for what we believe, and our self-accountability for understanding that everybody's not like us. And that's okay. We got a lot of mixed reviews about that, especially from most of the ladies, you know, because that's who we wanted to basically comment, you know. And a lot of ladies agreed that, hey, the woman who actually lied on Emmett Till, you know, she should have been actually jailed, you know. And a lot of people, surprisingly, most of the women, they didn't really say she should get the death penalty. You know what I mean? It was a few, but not a whole lot. But they were definitely saying that she should, you know, rot in prison. But it's ironic also that a lot of people were saying that, you know, look how old she was before she confessed it. You know what I mean? And, you know, I guess with Bill Cosby, I think the thing with Bill Cosby was that, you know, there's a lot of celebrities who were saying that, you know, he did the stuff that he did. But, you know, at least with Bill Cosby, he admitted, you know, that back then, you know, hey, they was giving out Quaaludes and, you know, it wasn't like you were drugging the women and they didn't know or whatever the case was. But again, that's basically, you know, his story. He came out and said it. He didn't deny it, you know. So obviously, you know, during that time in the 70s, you know, it's like everybody was sniffing cocaine and it was like the recreational drug. Heck, it was the recreational drug in the 80s, you know. But again, bottom line is we're talking about the Bill Cosby rape case. And, you know, the conclusion that basically we've come to, you know, here at WNLR New Level Radio, hearing a lot from the ladies on Facebook, social media like Twitter and Instagram, you know, ironically, a lot of them said that, hey, you know what? They really don't believe that Bill Cosby is more guilty than the woman who lied on Emmett Till. They actually believe they were equally as guilty, both of them. So, you know, that's a good perspective, you know. So I just wanted to go ahead and thank everybody for, you know, their comments, all the ladies, you know, for their unrestricted comments on Facebook and, you know, like Twitter and actual Instagram. So very good dialogue. But now we're going to come to what we call our new level of final thought. You know what I mean? So here's the new level of final thought that I have to say about the entire situation with the Bill Cosby rape case. You know what I mean? Ladies, this is my position, okay? Women are in control of their own actions. Sometimes they're deceived. Quite often they are. But the bottom line is, here's the new level of final thought with this Bill Cosby rape conviction. You know what I mean? It's got to be very, very, very difficult for somebody like Bill Cosby and what he's done for a lot of African Americans, for education, you know, even back in the days when he was, you know, doing Fat Albert, he was doing positive, you know, actual cartoons and everything. it's got to be very difficult for a woman who actually looks at Bill Cosby the way that she does, as a predator, as a monster. You know what I mean? And I want to be sensitive to that. But at the same time, unfortunately, you know, if you were deceived into, you know, taking a drink, you know, and something was, you know, they slipped you a Mickey or something like that. My thing is that ladies have to just really, really, really use a lot more wisdom. Things are not the same as they used to be. You know, you can't really trust every man. I mean, even if you go out on a date. You know, think about it. You know, the anxiety of you just going out on a regular date can't really be that high when you feel like, hey, this guy looks nice. He's very nice. You know, he's probably just trying to be a gentleman. You know, most gentlemen offer you a drink. Most gentlemen may offer you something to eat. You know what I mean? Even when you go out in public. So ideally, I think that my level of final thought regarding this rape case is that it took so long for women to come out and say their actual piece. I mean, more than likely because of the Me Too movement and everything. But the courage for women to come out, I can really applaud all the women who came out. You understand what I mean? I can definitely applaud them. Now, what I do say is this. I believe that if these women came out and they felt like I got to come out, you know, the bottom line is that you need to really understand what your coming out is going to do. Not necessarily for the initial, you know, attention or the conviction of somebody who did you wrong, who may have raped you. I mean, I really believe that all of those women who came out, every single one of them, I believe every one of them should be in counseling. Every one of them, if they already have it. I believe that it should be mandatory. I just believe that. That's my personal opinion. Because now you have done something that has drawn so much attention to you. You know, the social, you know, conception is that, okay, you're a scarlet person and you're just, you just have the scarlet letter on you like you did somebody wrong. No, I believe that if you're hurt and if you actually really believe somebody did something, there is a difference between believing that they did it and the actual evidence and the fact that they actually did something. Because unfortunately, you have a lot of women out here who make false allegations. And ladies, let me say this to you. The women who make false allegations make it really bad on the women who legitimately have complaints. And I believe that the dialogue should be between those women and the women who out here making these false allegations on good men just because they're being malicious, just because of their intention of being very vindictive. I really believe that the women who stood up to come out and really say that Bill Cosby did what he did, that same courage, I believe, should come out towards women who do the negative things. That's what I believe. If we have enough women speaking up for other women, or rather against other women, because most women speak up for each other, but very few speak against each other. And I find that to be very ironic, as opposed to men who always speak about other men. They always speak against other men. That's what argument is based on. But when you have women, because of the natural unity that women promote to be unified, again, I don't want to cause division of womanhood. I want to make sure that the integrity of womanhood is not compromised by the generalization of every single woman in the whole entire gender of women are interpreted to be good people. That's the bottom line for me. So again, my new level of final thought for all of this is that, ladies, you know, I really hope that you all seek the professional counseling that you absolutely need for your benefit, for all of the benefit of your children or your future relationship. Because again, clearly this is a sign of brokenness on your part. And this victory for you, for Bill Cosby getting, you know, convicted,
this is a victory for you, but the healing has yet begun. Because again, once Bill Cosby is gone, trust me, those feelings that you've had about him or what he allegedly did to you all, they're not going to leave. So the next man should never, ever have to bear that pain of what you actually convicted Bill Cosby for. And that is my new level of final thought. This is WNLR, New Level Radio. We signing off. We thank you all for tuning in. We hope you enjoyed the podcast. Look out for episode 2 coming right after this one. Peace, y'all.
WNLR, New Level Radio.